Hi viewers, welcome to Botany Point. Today I am coming with a new topic, that is nutrition in plants. So if you are a Hindi viewer, the Hindi video on this topic will be posted later. So today we cover what is nutrient, what is nutrition, mode of nutrition in plants and photosynthesis. And further topics will be posted on next video. Okay. So let's start about the nutrients. So see, first one is, what is nutrients? Okay, so nutrients mostly found in our food. Okay, the component of food which are necessary for our body is known as nutrient. That means what we take in our diet or daily food, that food contain some type of components. Okay, and that components are full of nutrients. Clear up to this? So here we can write that point. Those components of food are necessary for our body are known as what? Nutrients. So here the example of nutrients are carbohydrate, proteins, fat, vitamins and also minerals. So here examples are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Clear? So the food contains some component, okay, and those are most necessary for our body. Okay, and that components are mostly nutrients. That means nutrients are present in our food. Okay, so our food contain carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals. Clear? So it depend upon different food. Some food contain carbohydrates, some food contain maybe proteins. Okay, and it differs food to food variety. Then come to about nutrition. What is nutrition? Nutrition is a process. Okay, nutrients mostly found in our food, but nutrition is the process by which what happens? It mostly providing or obtaining in the food, and that is good for our or necessary for our health and growth. So here we can mention that point. See, the process of providing or obtaining the food which are necessary for health and growth, or you may write likewise, nutrition is the mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization by the body. Both definition is correct. Okay, so nutrition is the food contain the component. Okay, so inside the food some type of component forms. That means the carbohydrate with protein, some food maybe you found that inside that food, the food contain carbohydrate with some minerals and proteins. Okay, so proteins, the food are containing the what? The food contain the components. and their components are known as nutrients. And the process by which the what nutrition we obtain, nutrients we take here we nutrient take. So taking up that nutrient, the process is known as nutrition. Clear? The process of providing or for obtaining the food of the component of the food which are necessary for our health and growth known as nutrition. Clear? Okay. So this is our nutrient and nutrition. Now come to our mode of nutrition in plant. Okay. So mode of nutrition. Nutrition in plants. So before we know about the nutrition in plant, we should know about the mode of nutrition. Okay, mode of only the types of nutrition. Okay, nutrition. That is of mostly three types, but here we study about only two. Okay, so first one is autotrophic nutrition, and heterotrophs or heterotrophic nutrition. Tropic means process, tropes means group of organism. Okay, those are maintain such type of a particular category of nutrition, they are known as trope. Okay, that may be autotrope or heterotrope, but the process is known as tropic. Clear? Now come to what is autotrope and heterotrope. Auto means self. Okay, and tropic from the word tropes, that is trope means nourishment. Clear? Now hetero means what? Different or other, and tropes means nourishment. Clear? Here what happened, the autotrophic or the autotrophs, that the such type of living organism, they make their own food inside their body. And in case of heterotroph, what happened, they always, such type of organism always depend upon other food or other organism. Clear? So here we can mention that point, that is that autotrophs are or those animal, whatever you write is correct, those living organism make their own food. Okay, when they make food known as what? Autotrophs. Clear? And what is autotrophic? Autotrophic, the organism, the living organism, making food in their body or cell, making food, the process is known as autotrophic. So autotrophs are making their food inside their body, and the process is autotrophic process. Okay, now come to our hetero. Hetero means different. They always depend upon other. Okay, different or other organism, that may be what? That may be autotrophs or same category, maybe heterotrophs. So heterotrophs under two types of examples are there. It may be animals or human beings. So see here, the definition is those living organism depends on other for their food. Okay, the example are animal and human being. But here the autotrophic animal, this example is plants. So all the whole or the whole world, the autotroph or the example of autotrophs are only plant. Okay, plant. The plants are come under autotroph. Okay, and the animals and human beings are come under heterotrophs. So here what happened? Humans always what depend upon animals and also plants. So here the human is an autotroph and it also depend on a heterotrophs and also autotrophs. You know that from the animal means take the example of cow or cow that means milk product or paneer, curd, whatever the milk. Okay. That come from the world. Animal that the animal product like fish, that the animal product. Now come the our plants product, veggies and different pulses, whatever. So these are animal and plant products. So here human being depend upon both autotrophic. Human itself a autotroph, but it also depend upon autotrophs and also heterotrophs. Clear? So this is our autotroph and heterotroph. So here we only study about the mode of nutrition in plants. So how? That means the autotrophic nutrition. So see how the food production inside the cell. So before we know that, so we should know about where the plant is synthesized a product, produce their food. Okay. So the inside the plant, leaves are the food factories. Leaves are the food factories of plants. That means the production of food occur inside the leaf. That's why the leaves are known as food factories. Remember? Okay. Now come to about its raw material. So when we cook, we need no raw material. Okay. Without raw material, we can't cook. Like when we cook any dish or curry, we need what? Vegetable pulses or maybe any animal products, whatever. Likewise, leaf also need some raw material to cook their food. Okay, inside the what? Leaf cells. So here what happened? The raw material for plants, that is water, minerals, carbon dioxide and what? Sunlight. So these are the most essential for making their food. Okay, so leaf needs such material to what? To making their food. Or the plant need such material to making their food. Water, minerals, carbon dioxide and sunlight. Most important. Now come to about the process. In which process they make their own food. Okay. And the process is known as photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means food synthesis. Here the food preparation occurs. Photo means light. Okay. Photo means light. And synthesis means what? Production or the formation. Okay. So here the production of or the food, how the prepare in presence of light. That's why it's known as photosynthesis. If the light is not or the light is absent, then the photosynthesis is also absent. That means food production also stop. If the light is present, then only food synthesis occur. Clear? So for the synthesis of food, we know the raw material. Now this okay, now come to our definition first, then we discuss about the raw material. So definition is what is photosynthesis? The process plant can make the food inside their body or cells. Okay, the process is known as photosynthesis. Okay, making food known as photosynthesis. Clear? Now come to our raw material. Okay, so raw material, first one is water and also mineral. Okay, so water and mineral, where we got the water and mineral? So water and minerals are always found inside the cell, remember, and form the cell, which are helpful for to pull out or the absorb, that is the root. Through root, okay, root is absorb the water and mineral, and finally from the root different vessels are arises. Okay, vessels arises. So vessels are the transporting medium. Transporting medium which is helpful to what? Reach the water and mineral to the lip surface. Okay, so here from the soil root is absorb the water and mineral and through the vessels the substances, that means water and mineral, reach to the leaves. So here what happened? Vessels are small pipe-like cells which are helpful for transporting the substance, and finally it reach to the leaf surface. Okay, so here first inside the cell water and mineral is present, it absorbed by root and through the vessel. Now from the root, the vessel is what? Transporting the substance throughout the body of the plant, and finally it reaches to where? Leaf surface. Because the synthesis or food synthesis occur where? Inside the leaf. Clear? Okay, now come to our second thing, that is carbon dioxide. The raw material, that is carbon dioxide. So where it present? At atmosphere or the environment. The gas is present on the environment. So how it absorb or how it reach to the leaves? So leaves contain some small pore like structure. Okay, contain some pore, and that pore is known as stomata. So see how the stomata structure. So these are the stomata structure. This pore is known as stomata, and these are the guard cell. So stomata are surrounded by two guard cell. Okay, and through stomata contain the pore. So through this stomatal pore, gases, carbon dioxide is enter. Okay, and finally it reaches to the leaves, because this stomatal pore mostly found on the surface of leaf. So in the leaf surface stomata are found. Clear? Okay, now come the third point, is about sunlight. Sunlight comes from the where? Sun. Solar energy. Yes, see, the process is known as photosynthesis. That means presence of light is most important for the food preparation. Okay, so here the sun is known as the ultimate source of solar energy, because without the sunlight, food of the plant never make. Okay, so here we can define a point, that is, sun is the ultimate source of solar energy for all living organism. Okay, clear up to this? Now come to our fourth point, that is most important also, that is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green pigment. Okay, green pigment, that is green color in nature, and the chlorophyll found inside the cell, leaf cell, that is in chloroplast. The chloroplast contain the chlorophyll, which is green in nature, or the green pigment. And what is the function of this chlorophyll? Chlorophyll trapped or absorb the solar energy. Okay, so here the chlorophyll absorb sunlight. Okay, chlorophyll absorb the sunlight and for the process of food making occur, or the photosynthesis occur. Okay, so from the what? Likewise, how the carbon dioxide enter? Carbon dioxide enter where? Through stoma, stomata, and stomata present in leaf. Also, leaf contain some green pigment, that is chlorophyll. And chlorophyll found in chloroplast. Leaf contain chloroplast. Inside the chloroplast, chlorophyll occurs. See, leaf contain the green colors. Some of the cell subcellular particle, that is what, chloroplast. Okay, and chloroplast contain chlorophyll. Okay, and this can this chlorophyll, what the function of the chlorophyll? It trap the solar energy, or it absorb the solar energy. Then only further process of photosynthesis occur. Now come to about its reaction. How the photosynthesis occur? See here. So water plus minerals plus carbon dioxide in presence of what? Chlorophyll and sunlight. What happened? The formation of these are the raw material, and the product is what formed? Carbohydrates plus oxygen. Okay, so here what happened? From the reaction, carbohydrate and oxygen is formed. So the product or the food is the what? Carbohydrate. Now what happened? The oxygen, when it get contact or reacts with carbohydrate, now the carbohydrate become convert to starch. So the leaf contain starch. These are starch are the storage material of the leaf. The star are the what? Storage material or the storage product of the leaf. If we found that leaf contain the starch, that means the photosynthesis occur. If the leaves contain starch, that means what? Inside the leaf, that must be photosynthesis occur, or the food synthesis occur. Because in naturally, when the plant is growth, they never contain the carbohydrate product. By the formation, or the when the formation of photosynthesis occur, then only formation of starch occur. And finally, inside the plant, inside the leaf, starch are stored. Okay, clear? So this is about the photosynthesis. nutrient and nutrition. So again, I'm going to repeat this one. Listen carefully. See, nutrients are the components of food. Okay, so food contains some type of components which are necessary for our growth, and these components are carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins and minerals, and these are called as nutrients. Okay, and these are very necessary components called as nutrients. Now the process by which we take these nutrients, in that process is known as nutrition. The process of providing or obtaining a food which are necessary for our health and growth. Okay, so known as, the process is known as nutrition. Now the mode of nutrition in case of plant. So before we know that, so know about nutrition types. It is of two types: autotrophic, heterotrophic. Auto means self, hetero means different, troph means nourishment. So here what happened, autotrophic, here the autotrophs, the organism, autotrophs means the group of organism, those organism are, they can make their own food inside their body, are known as autotroph. Okay, and the process, the process which they own, they can easily make their food, the process is autotrophic process. Okay, and here also heterotroph, same, they depend upon other. Okay, they depend upon other for their food, known as heterotrophs. They can never produce their food inside their cell. So heterotrophs are, example of heterotrophs are animal and human beings. Then in case of autotrophs, all over the earth surface, only the one kind of autotrophs are there, that is plant. Only plants are autotrophs. Clear? And the plants, here autotrophs means they can easily synthesize their own food inside their body or cell. So here where they produce their food, in leaves. Okay, plant form their leaves, and from that leaves food production occur. That's why the leaves are known as food factory of the plant. Now come to raw material which are useful for the synthesis of the food. What the leaves use for their production of the food? Water, mineral, carbon dioxide and sunlight. Clear? Now come the process, how the food is making inside the leaf. The process of making food is known as photosynthesis, which is done by the presence of light. Without light, photosynthesis is not happening. That's why known as photosynthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means production. Clear? Now see here, what is photosynthesis? The process that plant make their food inside the cell, the process of making the food is known as photosynthesis. Clear? Now come about the raw material. See here, the water and minerals are mostly found inside the soil. So it absorbed by the root and finally it transported to leaves through vessels. So vessels are the continuous vessels. Vessels contain continuous vessels through which they continuously were transported the water and minerals to the leaf surface. Clear? Now carbon dioxide, how carbon dioxide get enter inside the cell of leaves? So it is entered through stomata. Stomata found on the surface of the leaf, and stomata surrounded by or guarded by two guard cell. Okay, and through the stomatal pore, carbon dioxide enter and finally reach to the place where the synthesis occur. Now come to sunlight. Sunlight also more necessary because the process is known as photosynthesis. Without sunlight, the photosynthesis does not occur. That's why the sun is the ultimate source of solar energy for all the living organism. Because why this term is coming? Because here the heterotrophs also depend upon autotrophs. Heterotrophs can't make their own food. Animal depend upon what? Plants. Women also depend upon plants and also animals. But if we take a human case, large amount of case, so human also depend on animal and that animal depend upon plants, and also human beyond the animals also depend upon plants. That means what happened, the autotrophs are depends upon autotroph and also heterotrophs. Finally, autotrophs are most important. Okay, autotrophs make their own food and they growth and develop, and taking that food by autotrophic animal, they also develop. Okay, and here what we know, that without any solvent, formation of the food is impossible. So here, that's where the term is coming. That is, solvent is the solar energy for all living organism. Clear about the chlorophyll. So this sunlight or the solar energy is absorbed by the chlorophyll. Okay, and through that process, photosynthesis occur. Okay, now clear about come about its reaction. So water, minerals, and carbohydrate in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, carbohydrates and oxygen form. So these are the raw material, and these are the what? Carbohydrate, oxygen are the product. So the main food is carbohydrate. Okay, and this carbohydrate, what happened? It converted to starch in presence of this oxygen, and this starch is stored inside the leaf for their food. Clear? So this is all about photosynthesis, nutrient and nutrition. So if you like this video, so please hit the like button, share, comment the botany point. Thank you so much.